everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to share a four-step process to help you easily prepare for interviews using ChatGPT. Common question I receive from coaching clients, what should I be prepared for when it comes to interviews? Be prepared for anything and everything. And I'm gonna share a quick story that illuminates this point. So a coaching client received an invite from a recruiter. Two people on the invite. He was on the invite and the recruiter. He thought it was going to be a casual conversation. Initial conversation, get to know you, discuss his background. Well, my coaching client joined the Zoom and there were six people staring at him. There was the recruiter, five leaders, and my client was astounded. He did not at all know that he would be embarking on a 45-minute rapid-fire panel interview. Was given no information at all by the recruiter. Big miss, by the way, I'm not sure. What happened there? There were five interviewers who each had 8 minutes to ask my client. They presented a slide deck with the questions. My client and I debriefed, and I think he was a little bit like struck. Kind of he had an out-of-body experience because it was like just so overwhelming. He's like, I think I did well, but honestly, I don't even know. And so he realized at that point, like he was going to over-prepare because he wanted to ensure that he was never caught off guard in future interviews. So I wanted to make this video to help you think about preparing for interviews using four easy steps. First, be prepared for the common interview questions. Tell me about yourself. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? And yes, that question is still being asked. What are your strengths? What are your areas of development? How would you describe your leadership philosophy? What motivates you? Tell me a time you failed. What's one of your biggest accomplishments? Just cover as many of those common questions as possible. Step number two is to be prepared for role-related interview questions. What I recommend, you take the job description, you take your resume. You want to marry the two. And what I mean by that is you want to have answers to questions that may come about based on the job description. So if there is a heavy emphasis on, say, cross-functional collaboration, you can select a project where you were engaged in cross-functional collaboration. Step number three, focus on company questions. And by this I mean when you're being interviewed, you're not only being assessed for your fit for the role, you're also being assessed for your fit with a company. I would think about the values of the company. Think about kind of the ideal candidate that may be hired. And what I would say is there's definitely been a shift from more focus on culture fit. Does this person think like the rest of us? Does this person have the same background? You know, are they going to fit into this box? More progressive organizations are now focused more on a culture ad perspective, especially if they embrace diversity of skills and thoughts and experiences and backgrounds. And so in these organizations, a company will be assessing you and thinking, what can this candidate add? The fourth step is to focus on questions for the interview team. And I recommend having a list of questions based on the role of the interviewer. So if you have a VP of sales, you have a director of operations, very different concerns for each of these individuals. So put yourself in the interviewer's shoes and think about what is most important to that person. And that will help you determine what should I ask this person that shows I really understand their role. So now we're going to dive into ChatGPT. It's a really basic tutorial, and it will help you cut down pretty dramatically on the time it takes you to prepare for interviews. So step one, we are going to ask ChatGPT, what are the top 20 most common interview questions that are typically asked of candidates? So here we have a list, you know, tell me about yourself, what are your strengths, your weaknesses? Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Tell me about a time you failed. And so what I'd recommend is creating either a doc or a deck and starting to address these questions I also highly recommend that you actually conduct mock interviews. Whether you hire a coach, you work with a colleague or a friend, you want someone who is going to provide constructive feedback to you. They're going to tell you if you're saying every other word. They're going to tell you if you have strong presence. They're going to tell you if you're going off the rails and you're rambling. So it's really important as well that you time yourself and you simulate the actual interview. So step number two, we want to focus on potential role-related questions that may come up. And so what I did is I found a program manager role at Starbucks. And I'm going to do a copy and paste and ask ChatGPT to provide a list of 20 potential interview questions based on this program manager job description. Okay. So we have a number of questions focused on program planning, program execution, leadership and communication, technical skills. Okay. You can then ask ChatGPT to prepare a list of potential answers to these questions using, say, the STAR method, which is situation, task, action, result. I know there are a number of different interview methods out there. Figure out what works best for you. Okay. And so ChatGPT will outline answers to these questions using the situation, the task, the action, and the result. And so I would think about, how does your experience map to some of these questions, and how can you structure your answers so you're being clear, you're being concise, and you're coming across as confident in your abilities. Third step is to consider potential questions that may be asked to assess your fit, as I mentioned, with the company. So can you devise a list of potential questions that will assess me as a candidate based on Starbucks values and culture? So example questions could be, now, Starbucks places a strong emphasis on creating a really welcoming atmosphere for customers. Can you tell me about a time when you created this warm and inviting culture? Starbucks emphasizes teamwork. Can you provide an example of a challenging project where you effectively collaborated with a team to achieve a common goal? So I would recommend you take time to review a company's website. You watch their YouTube channel if they have one. You understand the CEO and that person's mentality and approach to leadership. You do research on the products, even test them out if possible. And you really come across as someone who is curious, you're passionate, you're really excited about the company. So as I mentioned then, the fourth step would be to devise a list of questions for each interview. And you can plug in the job description if you'd like, or based on what you've learned throughout the interview process, you could ask for specific questions like, what is most important to the director of operations at XYZ company? Devise a list of interview questions. Or what may be most important to the CEO of this startup? They're focused on this. So that is the four-step process. You know, highly recommend implementing ChatGPT for your job search. It can help you in thinking more creatively about what questions may come up. And you can even have a back and forth, like, ChatGPT, what do you think about these answers? Do they fit into the STAR method? So if you need some help with interviews, please feel free to contact me. I absolutely love conducting mock interviews. I've worked with many different clients and they've been successful in receiving offers because they have prepared for anything and everything. So thanks so much. Stay tuned for the next video.